So you were awarded Baller of the Month. So congratulations. I just want to say that I watched you over the last couple of years since your first year in the league. And if, correct me if I'm wrong, but you weren't on the full starting rosters when you first got to.
Correct, yeah.
So it's been really nice to see how you've progressed as a player, just in terms of way you've been able to make a big impact on the court with your catching, your communication skills. So that's kind of why I decided to nominate you and why I'm really glad you're able to become Baller of the Month for November here. You're also the second person from UNL ever to actually get Baller of the Month. So congrats on that part. So first off, I guess, just how does that feel to be nominated and to win the Baller of the Month here?
Say it's really exciting. It's not something that I ever would have really expected. Kind of, I wouldn't say I'm like one of the greatest players of all time, but it's really exciting because I do feel like Dodgeball Club, it's something that I've enjoyed all of my time through here. And I feel like I've really tried to commit to the team, really tried to like improve my skills. And so like, I don't know, I think I'm proud of myself and the progress that I've made. So it feels really nice that somebody else was able to see and recognize it. So
in terms of just preparing yourself to get to that point, like what were the things that you kind of did to kind of just get better as a player? Was it extra practices or was it just having teammates, you know, throw at you really hard, that type of stuff? So
I would say, I don't know, a little bit of everything. I think one main thing for me was kind of just like changing my mindset. I feel like when you're new to the sport, you see the really strong players, you see like how good and talented they are. Kind of when you're beneath that level, it's hard to look at yourself and be like, oh, can I do that? Or like, how much can I improve? So I know for myself, I just kind of had to take a moment and say, go for it. You're going to get out many, many times in practice. But I kind of found like, I'm not always the strongest thrower. So I was like, okay, let's try to make smarter throws or like practice the reset throws and like at least be able to contribute in one way or another. And kind of similarly catching, some people throw it and it's scary to step behind it, but you get hit on accident a few times and then you're like, it's not that bad. And so I was kind of like, might as well try it out. I'm going to go for the catch. I'll miss some of them, but kind of just trying it out, you'll start to get better. You'll figure out the ones that you can catch and maybe the ones that you should block. And so for me, it was just telling myself to go for it. And when I did, it became easier. It all became less scary. I still make mistakes, obviously, but for me, that's kind of how I was able to grow those skills that I like saw weak spots in. And so, yeah, that's kind of what I did. And then I'd say having people throw at me when I wanted to improve something definitely helped. And so, yeah, kind of just lots of practice.
So my mindset to my new players and everything, I keep telling them, just go for it. If you get out, I don't care. At least you're trying, you'll get better. And like you said, kind of realized, oh, it's not that bad type of thing. I can actually do this. So I like that attitude towards getting better and stuff. So, but in case, so people don't really know, why don't you just kind of tell us where you're at in school and if you're on any type of board positions at UNL?
Okay, sorry. Just like positions within
the club.
So yeah, I'm a senior. So I don't know what semester of Dodgeball this is, but I'll actually be graduating in December. So kind of these last weeks here are my last as a whole. Currently, I am the president of our Dodgeball club here.
Then I guess a follow-up question to that would be, was that something you sought at, or was it someone on the team that kind of pushed you towards being as a leader on the team there?
Say a little bit of both. I think just myself as a whole, I like being in leadership positions. I like being able to like contribute to organizations that I care about and help improve them. So I definitely had my eye on some leadership positions when I was in my first couple years in the club. And then I think it was elections my sophomore year. So going into junior year, I was kind of toying with the idea of running for vice president, and I wasn't really sure. There were some areas I wanted to be able to contribute to. And I talked to our president at the time, who was Rob Gable, and he was kind of like, I think you should go for it. Like, if you don't run for it, it's harder to make like the improvements and changes that you think would help the club. And so he was kind of the extra push to just say, I'll run for it. And I mean, if I don't get elected, then like maybe I wasn't the best for this position. But yeah, so it's kind of a little bit of both. I thought I wanted to do it, and somebody helped give me the extra push.
Well, I'm glad he did, because I said, with your leadership and like the all overall UNL's leaderships, I've really seen really great things come off your guys' club the last couple of years. I know that the pandemic year has been kind of hard, but just kind of touched on how you guys were able to kind of get recruitment over the last 2 years, and such a big amount of recruitment for you guys. I think you had 26 members plus, I think, based on what you guys submitted for rosters. So I mean, that's really good for having such a couple of tough years and then having a good recruitment this year.
Yeah, I'm trying to think. Yeah, we have recruited super well this semester, and I would have to give a lot of that credit, to our Alex Page. He was kind of responsible for recruitment this year, and I think did a phenomenal job. Throughout last year with the pandemic, it was definitely kind of hard to retain numbers. And so say we kind of just kept having practices, even if it was only like seven or eight of us there, kind of show up, work on some skills, maybe call it early. But I think we still kind of all loved the sport and wanted to show up and keep getting better. I'm trying to think. I don't think we added that many numbers who joined last year specifically, but then this semester, yeah, Alex really stepped up, went to all of the events, made sure we were there, talked to a lot of people. And then we also got, there were some people who were active in the club 2 years ago, who kind of throughout the pandemic, we didn't see as much. And so I was really happy that a lot of, all of those players like came back and were still excited now that we could compete and kind of have those goals in sight. So yeah, I'm super pleased with the numbers. It's really exciting being able to come to practice and have like nearly full teams on both sides able to play.
That always makes it a lot more fun. Yeah, 4v4 isn't the funnest to try and improve on and things like that. So I definitely understand
that. It's exhausting.
Yeah, running the full court and everything. So, but one of the things that I've noticed again, another year, it seems like year in and year out, UNL does a really good job of recruiting female athletes, and not just, you know, recruiting to the team, but really talented athletes. I said, every one of them that I watched over the at Cornhusker class and the Pioneer Classic really impressed me, and I'm pretty excited to see where they'll go in the future. I know, do you want to just talk about how that every year, how you guys are able to kind of do that? Just, you know, it's just something that's, it seems like UNL is really good at versus compared to the rest of the league. So if you wanted to talk on that, touch on that.
Yeah, I guess. Honestly, I don't really know. I mean, I'm one here and stuck around, so maybe it's just because I enjoyed it. I'd say one thing in recruitment is I think everyone who's at the table is just as enthusiastic about girls who pass by than about the guys who pass by. And so kind of just like starting that first conversation. And so I think we have a lot of people like dodgeball sounds cool to women athletes as well. I don't think there's any like distinction there, but it's kind of when people show up to practice, I think even then there's kind of a difference in like the confidence when you walk onto the court. So that's something that I really care about, is maybe like making sure that like any female athletes we have out here, like you got this, like go for it. Don't be scared to try something, and just really encouraging them. I think that really helps people decided to come back. I think it's kind of one of those like create a space that like, well, encourage them to get there, and then just like be enthusiastic, be encouraging, like help everybody get better in the same way. And so I don't know, that's how I think we go about it, and I'm really happy that we do have so many female athletes. They're all awesome. I love them all. They're so fun to be around, and so I'm happy to have so many, but that's, I don't know.
Really
maybe
cool.
Not
things.
A great answer. I just try to keep them around.
I said it's a really cool thing to see, and you guys, and I said there, it just seems everyone on UNL's team is very a tight group. They're just really, it just everyone seems to want to, you know, help each other out, you know, improve. Like I've been saying in the articles, I think this is the best overall UNL team I've ever seen. So I mean, I've been in a league for quite a while now, so it's been, I guess, going on 10 years now, type of thing. So. It's just really impressive, top to bottom. I couldn't see any weaknesses. You know, you all had throwers, catchers. Even when your top players were out, you were still playing really well. So I was really impressed with that. So it's fun to watch, and then also we get good games out of it. So,
well, thank you. I really appreciate that. I know we all do this. We have fun doing it. So.
So I guess one of my questions is just to ask kind of like, how did, you know, back-to-back tournament weekends, first you guys traveled to Platteville, played two doubleheaders, and then you also played an alumni match in there, and then went back the next week, Platteville traveled out to you guys to play two doubleheaders and then a beat game. Just how you guys handle just kind of that kind of the back-to-back weeks with pain, you know, that kind of things like aches and stuff like that, how you guys handle that in terms just to stay healthy and be able to compete each week there.
Yeah, I would say a lot of that credit has to go to our captains and coach. So we kind of, Rob really encourages us to have a game plan going into the first tournament. So it was kind of 2 weeks out from there. We're like, we really want to like focus on like protecting ourselves, still practicing, but not getting any new injuries when we're about to play so soon. So kind of in those 2 weeks before we came to Platteville, it was focus on our weaknesses, like don't strain yourself, like kind of like focus on the things that you want to improve on before the tournaments, but like we're not expecting everybody to go 100%. We also try to really encourage people to like get ice after practice, take care of themselves, just kind of minimize those injuries. Also like learn if the motions you're doing are causing injuries. So if you're throwing in a way that hurts you, we try to prevent that before we hit the point. Not that we do a perfect job, but I'd say with these back-to-back tournaments, we kind of really focused on it. And then in the kind of week in between, we really focused on like areas that we could have been like could improve from the previous weekend. So at that point, we probably weren't going to make our arms significantly stronger and throw harder. So there wasn't a huge point to like go 100% throwing in practice and stuff like that. So kind of had a few conversations, took it easy at practice, said, here are the things we noticed and should work on. We also, something I thought was fun, both of those weeks, we kind of took the Thursday, we cut it short and just went out for dinner, which I think, I don't know, just kind of adds to the community, made us all have fun and be excited going into it. And so, yeah, I think we just kind of tried not to push ourselves and kind of just prepared mentally, had our game plan and strategies set up rather than pushing our bodies 100% right before then.
I said, well, you guys had your strategies, and I definitely say they worked. You guys stuck to them as what really, I said, impressed me. I said, you guys seemed like you were all healthy at the second week, which was fun to watch. You guys came back. I saw even more improvements. Too many team catches for my liking from my side, but we'll take it anyways there for you guys. So, no, it was really fun getting to go there, watch you guys. You know, it's just to see where you guys have come in just, you know, two short, you know, years here with COVID and everything like that. So what, for you guys, I guess, what do the wins mean against UWP, like in terms of just how you guys felt, like it was it big for you guys, like that kind of stuff. So
yeah, I would say it felt really, I don't know, they did feel big for us. I'm trying to recall correctly, I don't remember, one of our captains, Dustin, he's a lot better with the historical stats, but kind of the first like win we'd had against UWP in a long time, I think, at least for us, like my current class ever. And so that was really exciting. I think all of the new players kind of, you don't have the expectations when you're new to the team, but being able to say like right now that we're 4-0, I think it's kind of put us off to a really great start. Makes everybody just a little more invested in the team, invested in the club, and like seeing what our work at practice can do. So I think it's just, it feels really good to have something to show for it. Not that we like don't believe that we're improving, but when you're able to like hear that last whistle and you've won the game, it just kind of, it's like the cherry on top of like, we've worked hard. We see like where it's going and how we've improved ourselves.
So I guess, yeah, I don't know if you guys know yet, but you guys with your 4 wins, it moved you guys up into the top 10. You're currently ranked 9th. So I guess just get your first reaction from that. How does, I think that's the first time ever that UNL has actually ever been in the top 10. So congrats on that right there. So
thank you. Yeah, I know we definitely had lots of messages going back and forth after the first weekend of like, oh, our ranking has gone up. And so I'd say that's super exciting for us. I know it's kind of difficult in the Midway Conference because we don't get to play as many games or see as many like different teams. And so kind of it's hard when like there's so few people to compete against, but it's really awesome to just kind of show that like, I don't know, even like across the entire NCDA, like we are kind of working, improving, like there are exciting games going on here. Cause even both weekends, like very good games between us and UWP. So I think it's just kind of awesome to be able to show like, hey, we're competing out here. We're having these exciting games. Like we're improving, we're getting better. And so, yeah, I don't know. I think in all of my time here, I don't know about where we've like hovered in the rankings, but it's really exciting to just see like, oh wow, we made the jump. Like we kind of just, we did it, I'd say.
I'm pretty excited for you guys too. It's been awesome to see just the Midway Conference, just, you know, get wins, you know, excel and stuff like that. So I'm really, it's really awesome to see that, you know, I've said you guys put the work in and it's paying off, and hopefully it keeps paying off in the future here. So I guess kind of just to talk about that a little bit, do you know if you guys have any plans in terms of traveling next semester, if you're going to try to see if you can get to a tournament where you might see some other teams? I know at Platteville, we're going to try our best to try and get some teams out if you guys do come to ours, so you can see some other teams in action there. So well, for next semester, help you guys out. So, but unless you guys, you know, I see Miami has a tournament. I know long distance is everything, but I don't know if you guys have talked about that or if you're planning to. So,
yeah, it's actually, we were talking about it just the other day. So I think we're definitely hoping to come out to Platteville in that February date. And then it's kind of, for me, as I'll be graduating, I won't be part of the board, but all of our remaining officers were talking about the Miami tournament, and even the other day getting interest. And it seems like our players would be willing to hunker down, make the drive out there. And so I'm pretty hopeful. I think it'd be awesome if they're able to kind of figure out the logistics, able to get out there, or logistics needed. And so, I don't know, that'd be awesome. I'd be a little bit sad to miss out on seeing all the new teams, but I think it'd be really great for them. And it seems like they're trying for it. So they're excited about the opportunity. And so I expect them to, I don't know, do as much to make it possible.
So that would be really awesome. I'd love to be able to see you guys go out there. And I'm hoping I can convince the guys. I think it might be around our spring break, but at least, you know,
yeah,
to get them up there and, hey guys, you know, we can 1 or 2 days crash type of thing, then get you back home to your parents to enjoy type of thing. But it'd be awesome if you guys could go out and we could go out and then just, you know, we could all showcase our talent and stuff like that from the Midway. So that's really awesome. And then do you guys, are you planning, is Nationals, wherever it's held, if it's held next year, planning to try to make that out there, do you think, then, for UNL?
I think so. I think that's definitely been something we've had our eyes set on. Sorry, there's traffic outside. I don't know if you can hear that. But, yeah, I think, I know my grade, so all of the current seniors, kind of never been to Nationals. And so it's kind of been something, is we want to make it happen. And I know that all of the captains want to do it. I'm trying to think, because all of the juniors would have been freshmen when kind of the pandemic started. So I think, I don't know, it's like this mythical land that we'd all love to go and see. So I think everyone's going to try and do what it takes to make it out there. Absolutely.
I think the last time you guys went to Nationals would have been in 2018. Was at VCU, was at Richmond. So that was your first, I think, Nationals too.
It'd be nice
to be able to see you guys get out there again, just to have that up like that. Just a cool experience. So hopefully you guys can get out there and keep working hard on that stuff. So let me see here. Then I guess, do you want to just highlight any standout players from UNL, other than, you know, this, that you've been impressed with this year, or we should look out for from UNL then?
I guess one group of people I'm super impressed with is our captains. So that's Dustin Sprunk, Ethan Glenn, and Trey Summerall. I think it's kind of like last time we competed, we were all underclassmen. And so watching them really step into these leadership roles throughout the pandemic and become like leaders on court as well, and like really start making those big plays, I've been super impressed by. Also a couple players that joined last year and stuck with us throughout like that year without competition, Alex Schmidt and Dylan Mundy. I think they both performed like phenomenally in these tournaments. So kind of awesome to see that like even without the competitions, that year that they were showing up to practice has really like made improvements. I don't know. I think everyone on our team impressed me, so I could keep going and going. But I'm so impressed with everyone who's new this semester. I couldn't be prouder. They're all great, I'd say. But those are a couple that I think really stand out, had good stats, made good plays in these competitions and tournaments so far.
I definitely noticed definitely improvements from their first year in terms of just their throwing ability, catching ability. Those guys just overall just great to watch. And they really said, with you guys out there, you're commanding the court type of thing, it really made challenges for Platteville to get any gains, or when we had our chances to take points, all of a sudden they would turn it around with some big type of catch or something, just because of their great leadership out there and their court awareness and things like that. And I said, you're a freshman. I said, again, they really impressed me. I said, from top to bottom, you guys had just a quality team that it's just, you can't notice a difference when one person subbed in, another subbed out. You just really didn't see it. You guys all just played the same and just knew what your objective was on the court, which is fun to see. I'm looking forward to what UNL has in store next. So, but I guess my last question, I guess, for you, or one of the last ones, is just, what do you want us to know about UNL, the league, the NCAA and stuff?
Oh, that's a big question. I think, I don't know, I'd say like maybe since like you are our closest competition in Platteville and we're not able to have as many tournaments as like other schools are able to, that doesn't necessarily mean that we like aren't as excited to keep playing. And so like I imagine that both like all of the other schools, they have the same amount of excitement about this sport and really love it, even though we can't compete with everybody. There's just a lot of excitement out here. And I would also say that also translates into a lot of excitement to hopefully see a bunch of different schools at Nationals or in at the Miami tournament if we're able to make it out there. Just kind of, we're excited to keep playing, and I know everyone on the team would be so excited to be able to meet and play against new teams. So, I don't know. That's what I would have to say.
And I guess just last one, I guess, would be just for me is just, what are you looking forward to with graduation here? With it being done with school and everything, kind of what's your plans going forward?
So it's super weird, but I think I'm really excited. I don't know. I might be a nerdy prick. Well, I definitely am. But I do enjoy school. And so it's going to be a weird shift to suddenly not having that. But I would say kind of these last multiple semesters in the pandemic, it's kind of just changed my excitement towards it. So I have a job offer as a software engineer that I'll be starting in the middle of January. And so I'm just kind of super excited to be able to go out and apply what I learned and like contribute to something in the actual like workforce. And so, I don't know, it's super weird. It's gonna be a totally different day-to-day schedule, but I'm looking forward to it. It's at a place I interned, so I kind of have an idea of what I'm getting into. But those are what I'm most excited about. I am gonna miss Dodgeball though, I think. I've already told the whole team, I was like, tell me when you're hosting a tournament because I wanna come. I won't be that far away. And I'd love to come see them again, come see UWP, if hopefully you can make it down. I don't know that we'd plan one because other schools are further, but yeah, I don't know. I'm excited for my next step. I totally plan to keep cheering on our team though, so.
That's good to hear. It's always nice to have alumni being actively, you know, either watching the streams or, you know, going to the events. I know for me, it always means a lot, you know, to see my old teammates and even just for my players when old teammates come out and play against them. So that's awesome to hear. And I know that you're going to do extremely well with your job. Just with my experiences, everything I've ever asked you to help with in terms of getting your tournament registered, roster submitted, you know, you're very helpful, always really kind. So it's just made my job a whole lot easier as a board member. So I really appreciate that. And I guess good luck in the future to you. So.
Well, thank you. I really appreciate that. And say again, thank you to you for helping us navigate through kind of this year where last year we didn't have to do all of these things. So I really appreciated having somebody who's always looking out for us, helping make sure we get those done. So thank you.
Yep, it's no problem. So it's been a great time this semester so far. So hopefully another great semester comes for the Midway Conference. So
yes, absolutely. I'm excited to hear how it's all going and hopefully come see when I can.
So cool. I guess with that, we'll sign off. Robyn MacDonald, the Baller Month for November. Congrats.
Thank you.
Okay. Bye.